Today we're going to talk about how you can create TF2 server and also add an MGE mod in it. Although there is a guide here which goes in depth to tell you each and every step how you can actually create the guide. But some people requested me that still couldn't create the server, and I'm not trying to point their names out and stuff, but yeah. So let's get started. First of all, you will need the theme CMD, alright? So let's get that CMD and you're just gonna download it. There's it right there. Okay, so we got the Steam CMD right here. So now we need to create a file called tf2ds.txt and put this content. Alright, so we got the content in there. That step is complete. Next step, after that done, create a batch file, name it this, alright, and put this content in there. And just edit the content and put this in there, alright. So basically after that's done, all you need to do is just start this file and it will download all the necessary files for the server, alright. So we're almost done downloading all the files. So it's done. Alright, so make sure to change this folder name over here too, because you don't gonna install the server in this folder instead. So I'm just gonna move everything from here to there because I made a mistake. Should have done that. So now it should work. I'm gonna run update again just to be sure everything is up to date. Alright, and now we're going to create the config file for it. Okay, server.cfg. Now you can use the config from the website over here if you want more options, but I use the minimalistic one. So I have over here is some other stuff I need, and it's also kind of to let you know what this is for. So this is the name of the server and some options. I have to set this to 100 because some of the maps are more than 15 megabits, and this is used for fast EL. So if you have a very large maps, it's better to use a web server for them because it's gonna get slow downloads for a lot of people. Next step is to create a batch file to run the server. So you can copy this, go here and create a batch file. run-server.bat. Okay, so this server is going to run TF2 server with ST202 and map control point Badlands with 24 player limit. If you've done everything correctly, this will run your server basically like this. So basically this means the server is actually running right now, and so that's all you need to know. If you want to run a vanilla TF2 server, if you all you want to host is King of the Hill or a payload, etc. The default maps, if you want to load them, you don't need to do anything further than this. So this is all you need and your server is up and running. Now you will need to do port forwarding. If you want someone else to access your server, you will have to use this IP address and whatever written is at this place. This is mine, yours will be different. So this will work what your friends will use to connect to your server. If you're not sure if the server is running or not, you can use canyousee.me.org and type the port that you want to check, and it will let you know if the port is visible or not. I have not performed it on this router yet, so that's why it's saying that I could not see your service on this IP address. So this is the adminship tutorial, all that stuff. So I'm gonna basically skip all these and go directly to MGE. That's all that matters. So basically, to install MGE mod, you will need Sourcemod, Metamod, and STP hooks. Basically, if I click on this link, you will see something like this happens. So the links are pretty outdated on this, so we're gonna have to find out and install each and everything all by yourself. They have given us a Sourcemod link right here. So go into Windows and it will automatically show up. Just save the file. Now we're done. So all you need to do is go to TF folder, and then create, and then put these two folders in here. Alright, we need to close the files here. Okay, so this works. So we got both these, but you also need to download the meta file too. So we're gonna go with stable builds and download this. Even though there's folder for it already exists, but for some reason you have to download it again, and there are some files missing or something, I guess. So basically just put this folder and place all the files in there, and it should work. So now you have both of these mods installed. Now you need to install the MGE mod. The link is right here. This is the MGE mod link. And also, one thing is that the latest version of Sourcemod actually does include it does include the SDK hook files, as you can see over here. And this section 2 should be SDK hooks. Yep, it already does have SDK hook already installed in here, so you don't need to search and install SDK hooks at all. It already installed in the latest version that you find out of the website. Of course, all the links are in the description below. Here we go, we're gonna download the MGE mod. So we have the MGE mod right here. So you need to open the TF folder again and just put this file in there. Should have been replaced. Even from the first, I just do it twice just to be sure. So we got everything up and running. So everything should be installed now if you follow the guide correctly. And now you need to, all you need to do is just change the name of the map, and it should work with the MGE now. I'm also going to use this file here too, because if you're looking for an old class MGE, replace the old MGE spawns file config file in configs with this new one. So we're gonna do this too because we want all the classes. So this, and it's going to the CFG folder, and let's just put it in there. No, I don't think so. We're gonna put it there. We're going to add-ons, Sourcemod, configs, and we're gonna put it over here. Yeah, just replace it, and that's all we need to do. So basically right now, this code right there is, it won't work because the map name is different. The map name that came along with the MGE mod. Let me show you right now. Maps. So the name of the map is 4B and here is written 4A. Even though you write the correct name for it, but it still doesn't work for some reason. So we're gonna use a different map for it. Which is suggested by Spy Ones, and so the name is MGE Sucks. This is the map we're looking for. I also link this map in the description below too. So let's just download this map. We also need to download the spawn file too. So first of all, this map file is right here, and it's gonna go into maps. You should also put the default file there too, because it's a compressed version and it sometimes helps with loading times. So you should put both of these over here, as you can see, smaller version. Although the game will use the uncompressed version, but keeping this with it is always a good thing. And secondly, we got the spawns file right here. You need to replace this file with the default MGE file, which should be in add-ons, source mod and config. Yeah, but we're not going to do it because we got a slightly modified version of the MGE mod spawn file. So what you need to do is just put the code at the end of it. So I'm going to do right now. And we're going to scroll all the way down and search for the MGE socks map name. It is right here. Okay. So just need to copy that up. Just until this point, copy, and in the MGE file, this is in the source mod. You can see from URL, this is the file that is in server. So you just press an enter over here and put the code for this after this. And of course, I will also upload this file too. If you don't want to go ahead and mess with the config file, you can just replace it with my file. So with this done. Yeah, you have actually set to go and MGE mod should perfectly work. So we're gonna test out if our MGE mod works or not. So we're gonna run our server. Hold on a second, we just need to add it the map name before we run it, because it's all just running the CP Badlands. So we're gonna replace that with the name of our server. Going to TF2. I forgot the name of the map, so I'm just gonna copy this name. Replace it. So yeah, it should work now. Let's run the server. Alright, so as you can see over here, you can see that from this MG mod is actually working. We're gonna test it out right now. And where is the progress? There it is. I'm gonna test it right now. If it works or not. Alright, so you can either use the console. You just type in connect to connect to it, or you can just go to community servers and add your server in your favorites. In this case, you can just write in your local IP address over here, because I'm just gonna test it in my local IP address. So there it is, my server has shown up, zero people are playing on it, but I prefer this method a lot more. Alright, so let's try the add command, and yeah, it seems to be working, I guess. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and do let me know if you want this reel for some other mods. So yeah, do like and subscribe, and I guess I'll see you guys next video.